Hello everyone, welcome to Current Affairs Update series with Dr. Ved Pran. Topic for today's discussion is from reports and ranking section. So we'll be decoding Corruption Perception Index 2020, which has been just released, and there are some interesting findings in the report. So let's just decode what CPI 2020 has in store for all of us. So this topic can be asked in prelims, and also the data which will be just highlighted to you can be integrated in your mains answer writing or even in your essay themes, because this is one of the indicators which finds resonance with the examiners. So first and foremost, let's just decode the basics, that which is the organization behind releasing such report. It is none other than Transparency International. It's a Berlin-based organization which has been doing some remarkable work in releasing such data annually almost for a decade now, and more or less countries accept the ranking with a pinch of salt. Yes, the single score can never just clearly highlight what exact level of corruption is taking place. It is just the perception of corruption, which is through the businessmen or you could say the experts in the field. So the scoring of the Corruption Perception Index is a straightforward, but there are scores which range from 0 to 100. A score of 0 is likely to be perceived as the most corrupt, whereas if you are on the higher end of the spectrum, say 90, 85 plus, or you could say the 100, the ideal score, then it is likely to be that you are to be perceived as the least corrupt country. So countries would buy it to be on the higher end of the spectrum. Now, so which are the two countries which have excelled on these parameters as per Transparency International? If you have been following this report, then it should not come as a surprise. It's New Zealand and Denmark. With both having a score of 88, they have been perceived as the top performer this time, and more or less they have been consistent in their rankings, clearly highlighting that these are a couple of countries, and apart from the Scandinavian countries, which have been stood up in matter of governance, and corruption is not as permeative as is in the Asia Pacific region. Now the other side, because we need to have the both sides to be covered, if we have a top performer, there must be someone who has been a laggard, who was not able to perform well as per the requirement. So the African countries of, you could say, Somalia and South Sudan, they have been both tied at 179th position this time. So they have a score of meager score of just 12, clearly highlighting governance failure, and you could say the public perception of the corruption is highest in these two African nations. The index defines corruption as the, you could say, the misuse of the public power for the, you could say, private benefit. So clearly it's an indicator that the governance is clearly been permeating, corruption has permeated at the top levels, and the public offices are being misused for the private benefit. Now the key angle which we need to understand is how India as a nation has fared in CPI 2020. So if you compare the ranking, we are in midway. The ranking is 186, because 180 countries were assessed this in 2020, and India is in, has been ranked 86. There is a drop of 6 rankings, which is a matter of concern. If you look at the score indices, because that's a better parameter, India's score is 40. Now the 40 score is a slight improvement from the 2019 score. Last year we had the score has also been marginally changed. The last time the score was around 41. So clearly we need to improve our rankings, because the ranking has also been dropped. We need to move on the, at least in the top 50 countries, if we really want to be a developed country, or you could say we want to improve the perception of the governments. Now the key highlight of this CPI 2020 is that the president of the Transparency International has tried to link the 2020 year with the COVID-19, and it has said that COVID-19 was not just a health or economic crisis, it was also a corruption crisis as well. Countries who have done well in corruption perception index, they were able to manage or you could say COVID challenge in a better way than the countries which were at the bottom end of the spectrum. So clearly there is a linkage. If you have a governance which has you could say strict rules for corruption and they are tackling the balance with the iron hand, they are able to manage. Otherwise there are chances that your even the COVID response is not going to be adequate. So the pandemic has taught a lot of lessons, and the corruption was also one of the indicators where the linkage can be drawn. So you could prepare even the mainstream that how corruption and the COVID-19 are being related in 2020. So these are some of the key highlights which you need to mug up. I hope by now you are clear that who have been the top performer, worst, and India's ranking, and where we need to improve upon. Because clearly, with the score of running 40s and you could say ranking in 80s, this is not the ranking which you would be proud of. There is, we need to just buckle up and just set some short-term and long-term targets so that by you could say 2030 we are in the top performance, or at least in the top 30 nations. So this is what we have in today's ranking. I hope you find the session useful in some way. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.